Practice makes perfect, but it takes the right practice to get to the right perfection. In public speaking, practicing the right way involves practicing in front of your friends, your family members, your teachers, and sometimes your coach even. Sometimes you can practice in front of your mirror to see how you gesture and how you use your facial expressions. You can as well record yourself while you practice so that you can see areas that needs to be improved. But PowerPoint has bring in a new feature that helps us with all this. It is called Rehearse with a Coach. Now this feature can give you feedback as you deliver your presentations. It can tell about your pace. Are you too fast or you are too slow? It can even tell you when you use too many filler words. It can even alert you when you are reading directly from the slides. And at the end of it all, it's going to give you a comprehensive report with feedback. Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Rashimi, and welcome back to Epic Mentorship. In this video, I'm going to share with you three more tips: how to use Rehearse with a Coach in PowerPoint, how to design QR codes for your events and websites from PowerPoint, and lastly, I'm going to show you how to use the PowerPoint with various Zoom options as you deliver your presentations. If you are new here, consider liking and subscribing to our channel to keep enjoying related useful videos from us. Why don't you jump over to my PC to learn about these tips that I have for us today? All right, so the first tip that I have for us today is actually how to use the Present with a Coach. And to use this feature, all you need to do is to come to Slideshow over here, and you can navigate to Rehearse with the Coach. So it is welcoming you here to Rehearse with the Coach, okay? So once you start rehearsing, you can allow this ticked to see real-time feedback. As you are delivering the presentations, you can be seeing the feedback directly as you are delivering it. Or if you untick this, you're going to see the feedback at the end of your presentation. Okay, it is going to record everything we said and every feedback that it has as regards your presentation. But when you tick this very icon, it's going to give you real-time feedback, right? So let's say we start rehearsing, and let's see how it gives the feedback. This presentation is going to, you see, it's telling us that we are using too many, right? So in this video, I'm going to share with you three strategies on how to reuse slides, picture fill, and the new feature called dictate. You see, it's telling you to avoid reading directly from the slides because you notice that you are reading directly from the slides. All right, guys, this is a test on how the coach is being assessing our presentations. Okay, try varying the pitch and adding emphasis on keywords. So these are things that it's going to be giving you, and at the end of it all, you can see the result. Yeah. Okay, so these are direct feedbacks that the app is just giving you as regards your presentation. It gives you your pace, your pitch, your average pace over time, your summary in general, and your fillers. Okay, and then repetitive language. Whether you use any kind of language that is out of the box, it can give you that particular report. So this feature is quite handy for people who are interested in practicing and receiving feedback as they deliver presentations or speeches. Right, guys, so the next tip is how to use Microsoft PowerPoint to generate QR codes. You know, QR codes are becoming handy nowadays because they are being applied to store data such as email addresses, websites, you know, URL links that can be accessed easily to different kind of awareness or campaigns. We can even store phone numbers as the case may be. So it's a new feature, and to get there, you just have to come over to insert and get to get add-ins, right? So I'm clicking here, you're going to come over to this store, okay, and just type QR and hit the enter. So you can see it over here. So you can just add and come over here and say continue. So it's going to add up as a new add-in to your Microsoft PowerPoint. You can see it over here to the left. And if you have already added it, you can always come over to my add-ins and you'll see it over here. So this is a very handy feature. As you can see from the top here, you can use it to store website, secured website. You can even put your email address, your phone numbers, SMS, and your location, and even make it customized, right? And down here, you can change the color, you can change background color, and you can resize it to make it a little bit bigger or smaller according to your liking. And once you are done, you can just hit the insert and insert it in any kind of document that you have. So for example, let's say we are putting in my website, that once you hit this, you go to my website, drabdulrashid.com. Now, let's say we are putting in my website, and once you hit or you scan this document, it's automatically going to take you to my website. So once you are done with the design, you can just hit insert and you have it in your slides or in your document as the case may be. So this particular barcode is scannable by any device that can scan barcode. The last feature that we are going to learn today is actually how to use the zoom option in our slides as we deliver our presentation. So to insert the zoom option, we need to come to insert here, and then you can navigate to zoom here, and you can start with the slide zoom. So over here, you can select the various slides that you want to work on. For example, I select these five slides, and then you insert. Okay, you can click out, then you select the slides according to how you want them to navigate. For example, this is slide one, this is slide two, and this is slide three, this is slide four, and I want to have this as my slide five. Okay, the way we arrange it, that's how it's going to go. So now all you need to do is to start your presentation and then navigate to that particular slide where you want it to start. So click on it, it's going to show that slide, and once you move to the next slide, it easily navigates. And to the next slide, you can see, and the next slide, okay? And then it will take you to the fifth slide. So that is the power of the zoom option, okay? You can use it for your presentations. All right, another thing you can do is you can insert the zoom using different options. For example, you can come here and insert using summary option. I always prefer this because it gives you, maybe when you are delivering more than one presentations or maybe more than one sections, you can deliver it in section one, section two, and section three, and the presentation is going to be categorized according to these sections. So for example, you select section one, you select section two and section three as you define it in the slides, all right, and then you hit on enter. So this is going to bring you to a summary section. For example, let's try to play this and see the effect. So I'm coming here and clicking on section one is going to take me directly to section one, and then on clicking next, I'm going to go straight to the slides under section one, and once I'm done, it's going to bring me back to the summary page. Then you can go to section two. Okay, as you click section two, it's going to go to the next slide until it finishes, then it comes back to the summary page, and then you can go directly to section three. Okay, section three will continue until it finishes, then it will go back to the summary page, which is very, very handy and easy to use in your presentations. All right, guys, thank you so much for being with me up to this point, and I do hope that you have learned something today. If you do, feel free to share with your friends. And don't forget to always hit the like and subscribe button to stay connected with this channel for more of our useful videos. And remember to keep practicing, because practice is the only word that can get you close to perfection. See you in my next video. Bye.